Hey guys, Great Cubing here, and welcome back to another video. Today, I'm going to be doing a tutorial on the Ivy Cube. First of all, try and figure out how the puzzle moves around, because that will help a lot when you're solving it, because if you don't know how it moves, you won't be able to solve it. Okay, now that you know how the puzzle moves around, we won't even need to be using notation for this. We'll just be using some simple commutators. But what is a commutator? A commutator is moving a piece, for example, this yellow one, somewhere, then hiding it, and then redoing those moves. And then now it's up here, and not like a lot of the other puzzle hasn't changed. So let's get into it. So first of all, I'm gonna start on the white side. So I'm gonna find where the corners are. They're right here. So I'm gonna turn this, so now there's two corners facing up. And I'm gonna try and find where the white is. In this case, it's on the bottom here. So I'm gonna turn it like this. So now it's right next to it, so it can just go up here. So I'm gonna do the commutator where I move it there. Then I'm gonna hide it. Then I'm gonna redo those moves. And now I have the white side solved. Next, I'm gonna flip the cube over and do the yellow side. Because if I have a 3x3, white is opposite of yellow. So I'm gonna solve yellow next. So right here, I see that there's two pieces here, one here. So I'm gonna do the same thing that I did with the white, where I put the yellow corners up. So I'm just gonna do that right here. And in this case, it actually did solve the yellow block. Here's another case where I have the yellow corners on the top, but this yellow block's on the bottom. And again, I still have the white side solved. So I'm just gonna do the same thing that I did with the white, where I move it up, I hide it, I redo those moves. Now it's on the top is yellow, on the bottom is white. So in this first case, there is no side that's solved except for the white and the yellow. So as you can see here, no other side is solved. So what we have to do first is we find a piece that needs to move up. In this case, this green block needs to move up here to create a side. So we're gonna do the same thing that we did before, where we move it up, we move it away, then we move this back, and we move this back. So now we have the green side solved, and the yellow, and the white. And now we have one side solved. And this is another case you can get, where now that we have one side solved, we just need to solve these last three sides. So how we're gonna solve this is we're gonna do the same thing we did to solve one side, and we're just gonna move, in this case, the blue. We're gonna move the blue up, and we're gonna move it out of the way, move that back, and finally move that, and it's solved. Okay, I scrambled the cube up again, and we're just gonna do a little recap. So first, we need to move all the white pieces to the top. There we go. Now I need to move this block here. And then we're gonna do a commutator, so I hide it. I move this piece back, and move this piece back. So now we have one side solved. Now I'm gonna do the same with the yellow. So here are the two yellow corners. One right here. I'm gonna move them to the top. And doing this will not affect the white. In this case, it just solved it automatically. So in the first case, it solved the entire yellow side, but now I have a block here, which isn't good. So I'm gonna move it up, move it away, and redo those moves. And now we have two sides solved. Now the last step is getting these final three pieces. If you have four pieces to solve, just do this algorithm twice, like I said before. So since there's one side solved, we don't want to touch this side. So I know that green can go into here, but if I were to move this and I move it out of the way, it's affecting this red side. So instead, I'm going to pick a different side, for example, the orange. So I move the orange up, move it away, move these two back, and it's solved. Finally, I'm just going to do one solve, and you can see how fast I am at this. So you get a reference for how fast you can be.
face down on a pillow of shame. There's some girls with a needle trying to spell my name. My body's not a canvas, my body's now a toilet wall.
There we go, I solved it in 16 seconds. I'm gonna show you that right here. Or you can look on the screen here. Thank you guys for watching, I really appreciate it. And I hope now you can solve the Ivy Cube. Bye.